We have seen certain changes which take place during the process of fertilization. The next change is, this is the fifth thing which is happening. The sperm lysins have been released, all the membranes are dissolved, and now the sperm actually touches the membrane of the egg, that is the cell membrane. And that triggers initiation of meiosis II. So here, start of meiosis II is going to take place. Because this division, that oogenesis, was arrested in meiosis I. That means the cell which is there, this is the secondary oocyte, and it has all the layers around it. At a point, the sperm has come in contact with the membrane by dissolving all the layers around it. And this contact also helps in dissolving of the membrane. So membrane is dissolved, there is a reception cone which is formed, and the membrane dissolves so that the nucleus of the sperm can enter into the egg. At this time, the division is going to get triggered. That means the secondary oocyte will now divide to form the egg or ootid. And again, if you are able to recall the division steps, we said that this is the secondary oocyte. When it undergoes meiosis II, then it is going to form the egg, that is the haploid female gamete, and a small polar body, or the second polar body, would be seen. So when the division is taking place, it is inside those cell layers. So when this division takes place, the egg is formed, the layers are all around it, the sperm is already in contact, and there is a small cell which also appears here, which is also surrounded by the same layers. And this is the second polar body. That means now meiosis is complete. So egg, that is the female gamete, is ready. The nucleus from the sperm is about to enter, and this division has resulted into complete cytoplasm being retained by the egg, and little cytoplasm goes with the second polar body. Now, during this time, there are certain chemicals which act. The division was arrested. So here, metaphase factors which were active by keeping the cell in the metaphase stage, they are deactivated. And that is why when metaphase factors are deactivated and anaphase promoting factors are activated. So it was in this stage, it remained there because the factors were promoting only metaphase. Now after that, these factors, they get deactivated, anaphase promoting factors are released, which would promote the further steps, and that is how the division is completed. Now the next change which is going to take place, these things happen pretty much simultaneously. As soon as the sperm touches, meiosis II starts, and the next change also starts. Next change is actually known as cortical reaction, or it can also be termed as formation of fertilization membrane. So cortical reaction or formation of fertilization membrane. Once we see how this membrane is formed, then we'll talk about why this membrane is required. So now let us say that this is the egg, and I'm just drawing the membrane part. And we'll just stretch it. This is the membrane. Beneath the membrane, there is the cytoplasmic content. And if you're able to recall the structure of the egg, we said that the outer cytoplasm is known as exoplasm, which is dense, and the inner one is ooplasm. So this is the membrane, the vitelline membrane. This is the outer cytoplasm, which is known as the exoplasm. and the inner one is ooplasm. In the exoplasm are present some granules, and because of it, it appears dense. These granules, they are called cortical granules. Now, as the sperm touches the egg, meiosis II starts. At the same time, the vitelline membrane starts to rise above the cortical surface. That means the cortex remains here, and there is a space which appears between the cortex and the vitelline membrane. So now here, let us show this membrane going little up. So there is a space which has developed between cortex and the membrane. This is known as perivitelline space. And in this perivitelline space, these cortical granules from the exoplasm are released. So these cortical granules, they come into this space, and the membrane is separated from the cortex part. And these cortical granules, they go and attach on the inner side of the vitelline membrane. And now, this vitelline membrane, which has been lined by this cortical granules from the inner side, is known as fertilization membrane. And the name cortical reaction is given for the same reason, because these are the cortical particles which are released into the perivitelline space. So these are the granules present in the cortex which actually line or get arranged on the inner surface of the vitelline membrane. So this fertilization membrane is formed. Now coming to the significance, what is the role of this fertilization membrane? It prevents polyspermy. Polyspermy means no more than one sperm should fuse. Because after fusion of one sperm and one egg, the normal diploidy has been attained. If one more sperm fuses with it, it would result into change in the chromosome number. So as soon as one sperm touches, it has to prevent the entry of other sperms into the egg. And that is why this reaction, cortical reaction, takes place, or formation of fertilization membrane takes place. After this, now the nucleus of the sperm comes into the egg. It follows a path, and then fusion will take place. So only last step in fertilization process is left, that is the formation of zygote, that we will see in the next part.